Welcome, Dr. Naik. We would like to talk to you today about something which is, I think, very close to your heart, and that is the geospatial policy. What are your thoughts on that?
I think the most important should be that the information or the data, whatever we collected by the public agency, should be available to all concerned. That should be the primary goal, because I think today, if you see the kind of information which right from the citizen to the government or to the community as a whole is very critical. And my experience says that whenever the information is available to any community, like a farmer or a fisherman, their productivity improves. And once the productivity improves, the kind of benefit which comes to the country as a whole is much, much larger than the amount of money which we have spent on the collecting that information itself. I'll give you a very small example. Is like typical satellite will cost you around 300 to 400 crore. We use satellite information for fishermen, and the annual benefit is something like 34,000 crore. So I think we need not worry about retrieving the cost of that data as such, which you may get some money, but if you make a useful application out of the information, which will earn you 100,000 times more than actually what you spent.
So then would you advocate something like open data?
Yeah, I think open data, and except there are certain which is, there may be a security which should be very minor, you know, 5-10%. Most of the data, I don't think there is any strategic importance or security from security angle. And that data should be made available. And so people can generate, you know, variety of different applications. And I have also seen that using the information, even if you generate the information, how easily you can make use of that information also needs a lot of innovation. So if you make that information also available, the people can make use their own product and make use of it. I'll give you a very interesting example. When we were giving the fisheries charts in Veravel, initially they were a little complicated, you know, not very easy for fishermen to understand. So one young fellow started looking at it, made it simple, and started selling that information, 20 rupees a map, to each fisherman. So since this was available on your web, he could make this further value addition, and yeah. So I think open data, I think, should be the fundamental goal of any geospatial policy.
Because it will give rise to innovative use.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay. One of the issues that is coming up continuously is when there are private agencies who are involved in data supply and so forth, then they feel worried on this open data concept. They say, for government it's okay, but we can't, you know, for us sale of data is very important.
There are, some merit in this. But also, I would look at from a different angle. If your job is only to collect the data, it may be okay that you keep with you. But your job is not only to collect data, and you collect the data also, you build your services. If you keep your data open, I think your services also will improve, and it will get much wider acceptance, for a very simple reason, because when I use the data, I am satisfied with the quality of the data, and I would be more inclined to get for that services, because I know what kind of data is going in. If I am not sure about the data which is being used to provide that service, then I may use, but I won't be that confident. And this is what happened, of course, not a private sector, but in INCOIS, we made the entire data free, and that improved our services so large. I mean, today, most people, like fishermen, 93% fishermen uses the data, because all data is open, so people are sure what kind of information is being generated on the kind of a quality of data.
That means actually it's not just the data which is important, it is the packaging of the data into a service or a service oriented product. That is what is important.
I fully agree with you. I think simply giving data today will not make a sense because how you derive the information or a new product from the information also very much depends on your understanding of the data. And if you have built your sensors or processed that data, I think the kind of insight which you have on the data, everybody will not have that. And that I think we need to cash on and build services. Only data may not be sufficient.
We should have a geospatial policy that actually encourages this kind of packaging.
I agree. Encourages, and that will, you know, I'm sure that will lead to variety of new applications, innovative applications, or even the same with much more ease. Lot of mobile applications now happening, and I think that is the most important, because practically every Indian has a mobile today. So anything which is based on that ease, if you can see on your mobile, I think it will make the dramatic change.
One of the things that worries me in this policy is we only keep talking of data. Who can get the data, who can't get the data, and so forth. We never talk about the ultimate use of the data and a continued use of the data. Can a policy talk about that?
I think so. Because what I believe is today technology allows us, in the sense that if we say that this data is restricted, okay, I have no problem with that. But if I want to use that information and to generate some product which is non-restricted, say, you may say that height is restricted, fine. But if I derive a slope which is not restricted, I should be allowed to do that, in the sense that you keep your data with you. I am not going to take your data, but allow me to take out the information which I generated out of the slope. I think that today's technology can allow. I don't need to take data to my computer to get any information from your computer. So we should be allowed to use even restricted data sets to derive information which is non-restricted and make use of it. So I think if you allow this, my experience is that 90% of the applications doesn't need absolute height. What it needs only either relief or a slope, which is not restricted. So I don't see a problem. Only thing is that the people who has the data should be create a facility to make that data available for use, not to take it.
And one more thing which I was thinking about is that, you know, you mentioned this, that you don't have to get the data into your computer, but you have to access it. Which means we can think of things like going on the cloud and so forth.
Yeah.
But again, our policy, does it allow? That is the question.
I would say cloud, there could be issues, but I would say distributed database.
Okay.
So suppose I am a primary generator of a data, say on forest, the data will lie with me. But others have an access to my data, and since I am using his server, he would know what kind of data I am taking out, which should be non-restricted.
Today, you know, we can use 1 meter data freely, right? So I take the 1 meter data and I map a restricted area. Let us say I map a coastal area, right? Now, the moment I have made a map of the coastal area from 1 meter data, but because it is coastal area, so that it becomes a secret map.
I'm not very sure. In a sense, yes, this interpretation is definitely made by many. But I personally think it is not true. I mean, it should not be true, because the information which I take it out should be restricted or non-restricted, in my view.
Yeah.
Because if I generate a map of a vegetation, it's not restricted, okay? But if you show a variation in height, maybe yes, okay. So I think if the information which is restricted, that only should be restricted, not the derived information from that. Otherwise, you know, practically everything will become restricted if you use that as a criteria.
Now, policy does not give any room for interpretation.
So, I think we need to be very careful when we say that whether this data is restricted or non-restricted. My view is that the most of the time government depends on the scientists for the views. And if the scientist says this data is restricted, then it becomes restricted.
That's dangerous.
Yeah, but that's what happened when the sea surface temperature data earlier was restricted. Because in 60s, when it started coming, Professor Pisharotti said this could be, you know,
used for medical purpose.
Yeah. So it became restricted. And then when we afterwards realized that it's not, like recently we argued with the government and got the seismic data, made it available to the international on real time. Because we argued that if you want real time data for your purpose, you have to share it. Okay, you don't share all 100 station data, but you share 4 station, 5 station, whatever is feasible. So government, if you argue properly and if you put the case, I have found that they're very open and there is nothing they want to stop. It is our colleagues only, because somehow they feel insecure and they want to put everything as a restricted.
Well, it's been very nice talking to you, Sailesh.
Thank you very much
for sparing your time.